back. Day three of week two online. Tomorrow, don't forget, we're going to try to have our test. We're going to get to the Book of Ruth today. And the test is going to cover everything from last week, right? So that was all of Moses, the Moses story. It's going to cover Joshua. It's going to cover the judges. And then now Ruth, okay? So it sounds like a lot, but we kind of condensed and abbreviated a lot of those notes, so it wasn't as much, especially the Moses notes in Exodus. We kind of fast-forwarded there a little bit. Okay, same thing as yesterday, though. We're going to try to keep this video short. So here we go. Let's get into it. So why are we looking at Ruth? Well, same thing with Deborah. It's kind of rare to get a book, an entire book, named after a woman in antiquity, right, in the olden times that the Jewish authors are writing in. And with Ruth, you're going to almost see the inverse of the Judges and Joshua stories, is that instead of it being about violence, there's no violence. Instead of it being about all about me, you can think of Samson, right? It's actually about selflessness. It's about patience and loyalty. So instead of betrayals and death and destruction, you're going to get the opposite. Now, a little bit of that does come from the idea of sort of that motherly love that comes from the female perspective on the world, right? The male perspective, always about kings trying to dominate the world, right? And so you kind of get this inverse. And so when people tell you, oh, the God of the Old Testament's always about violence and destruction, they're probably not thinking about the Book of Ruth. We kind of skip over it, right? So main themes, you're going to see, King David is hinted at now in the Book of Ruth, okay? The main themes is that God's going to work goodness out of even the darkest situations. A good thing to remember, of course, where we're at right now with the coronavirus. And then it's also going to show the lineage or the connection of how do we get to King David, right? So David obviously is the biggest king in the Jewish history, but you might want to think about their implications from the line of David all the way to Jesus, right? So that's why David's so important, specifically for our class when we're looking at Christ in Scripture. It's through David's line that we get Jesus. So we're getting a little bit of history of Jesus' own family. All right. So, story of Ruth and Naomi. You got these are actual photographs taken. No, they're not. Okay. So Naomi, she is a widow, meaning that her husband has since passed away. So she has two sons. One marries Ruth. That son dies. And so at this point, Ruth is then free to kind of go back to her own family, like her own, where her family's from, because now she's also a widow. And again, you got to think in antiquity, you hear often about taking care of the widows, because if they didn't have a husband to provide financially for them, you know, some kind of job and provide the house, oftentimes being a widow, you were kind of on the outskirts of society. You were outcast. So rather than leave Naomi, now who's older, to be outcast in society, Ruth decides to stay with Naomi, even though now there's no sort of legal or familial connection with her husband also being dead. So Ruth accompanies Naomi all the way to Israel, okay? So Ruth, not necessarily associated with the Israelites at this point. So she accompanies Naomi to Israel. And then Ruth says that she is going to make a covenant with God in the fields of Boaz. And one of the things you're going to notice about the story of Boaz, again, check out the Bible Project video for much more details about this, is that Boaz is the opposite of Samson, where Samson is strong and morally weak. Okay, Boaz is not weak and morally strong, but Boaz is much more committed to God, and you're going to also notice the loyalty and faithfulness in Boaz as compared to the selfishness or self-centeredness of Samson. Okay, now it all works out in the end, and they have a child named Obed. Why do we care about Obed? We're not really going to look at Obed all that much, but Obed has a child named Jesse. And we do care about Jesse. In fact, if you were paying attention to the readings recently at Mass, we talked about Jesse. And then from Jesse, we get David. And some of you may have made like Jesse trees back in the day. That's where we get the family tree for David. Okay. So what about Boaz? We kind of skipped over him in the last slide. So here we go. Whole slide on Boaz. Boaz means in Hebrew, in him is strength. Right? Christ, we know, means Savior. Boaz, he feeds Ruth, right? And you're going to see this in the Bible Project, the similarities between Boaz feeding Ruth and Jesus feeding the 5,000. You're going to see that Boaz marries someone outside of Israel, meaning the Gentiles, right? So this connection to the outside world. So from God's chosen people, the Israelites, Mary and Ruth, someone not from Israel, right? And same thing that Jesus is going to espouse himself to the whole world. That he takes on the whole world as his bride, and he is the bridegroom, right? And then finally, Boaz says that he's going to spread his wings over Ruth. You can kind of like say that. I promise to give my life to you, protect you. And of course, this is the exact same image that we kind of find on the cross, right? That Jesus has spread his arms out for the entire world, saying, you know, in this sacrifice for you, I dedicate my entire being over to you. Okay, so you're going to see a lot of similarities again between Boaz and Christ. So hidden within the Ruth story is also Boaz as a type of Christ. Okay, again, I know that was really fast, but again, trying to keep these videos a little bit shorter for you guys. So tonight, what are you going to do? You're going to study the Ruth story. You're going to study the Joshua story. You're going to study the Judge story. You're going to study the Moses and Exodus stories. There's going to be a test tomorrow, and you'll find it on Canvas, and you'll have 24 hours to complete it. Okay, so the same thing as before. You can kind of come in and out of the test. You don't need to take it all in one sitting, although it's best if you did, right? You don't want it looming over your head all day. And I know that you could look at your notes and get a perfect score, but really I want to encourage you to do your very best to study beforehand and then take the test, right? Study beforehand, sit down, take the test, don't be looking through your notes. I can't obviously stop you from looking at your notes, but you know, do your very best to study for it just like a normal test, take it like a normal test, because that's how you'll know you really know it, right? And the things that we really want to focus in on are going to be these connections between types of Christ, right? Joshua is a type of Christ. How is he a type of Christ? Boaz is a type of Christ, right? And then also some of the other things about election. Why does God choose Deborah, who is maybe not someone you're going to think about to pick? Okay, so that might be a short answer question or something like that, all right? So think about those things, and if you have any questions with the test, what's on the test, what the format of the test is going to be, I'll tell you right now, it's going to be multiple choice, true, false, some matching, and then probably one or two short answers, okay? Not as intense as some of the other tests, okay? So we'll come back on Friday. I will have a video responding to some of the questions from the test, and then if you need any help with the test, don't forget to email me or post in the discussion board, and then I will see you guys on Friday.